So let's explore pulleys and let's answer the question, why are pulleys useful? So a pulley is simply a machine that provides us with an advantage by decreasing the amount of force required to lift heavy objects. So let's suppose we want to lift a very heavy box from the ground to our second floor apartment. Now we can either take the box and carry the box to the second floor, or we can use a pulley system. If we use the pulley system, the amount of force that is required to lift that box will decrease as compared to the amount of force that we need to apply on the box to carry the box via the staircase to the second floor. So we normally make the assumption that our cord, our string, is both massless and flexible, and our pulleys are frictionless. By making this assumption, we're doing two things. We're assuming that our force at any given point along our cord is exactly the same. It remains undiminished. And we're also making the assumption that the work done in both cases is exactly the same. In other words, the work, the amount of energy that we need to input to carry the box from the ground to the second floor via the staircase is exactly the same as the amount of work required to use our pulley. So the work in both cases remains the same, but the force that we need to apply in the pulley system is less than the force we need to apply when we carry the box to the second floor. So let's label our two systems. Let's label all our forces acting on this pulley and on this pulley. So here we have the following string going downward. By the way, this entire cord system, this entire string system, is one continuous string, one continuous cord. So that means the tension pulling upward on this side of the string is exactly the same as the tension pulling up here. So let's call this force tension and force tension. So two force tensions are going up, and our force of gravity that's pulling on this box is pulling downward. But on this side, we have the pulling force that we're pulling on this string, on this cord, and we have that force of tension. So this is force of tension because our force in the string is exactly the same. So let's do the following example to see why using a pulley is more advantageous than simply carrying the box to the second floor. So let's suppose the box has a mass of 100 kilograms. We want to find the advantage of using our pulley. So let's find what the force is required, what force is required to lift the box without the pulley. So we have the box. The box is a mass of 100 kilograms. Here we have two different forces. We have the lifting force that we need to lift our box with and the force of gravity. So let's set them equal to zero. Let's take the sum of these forces. Let's choose upward to be positive, downward to be negative. So we have the sum of the forces acting along the y-axis is equal to force lift, the force with which we need to lift our heavy box, minus the force of gravity, equals zero. In other words, we're essentially asking ourselves, what is the force required to lift our heavy box without the pulley? So we bring this to this side, we set them equal, and we find the force, or the lifting force, is equal to force of gravity, so mass times g. Our mass is 100 kilograms times 9.8 meters per second squared, and the force with which we need to lift our heavy box is 980 newtons. What about if we use the following pulley system? So we have the same exact pulley system. Well, we have to set up two equations, one for this side and one for this side. So this here is the force with which we need to lift, with which we need to pull on our object. And this here is our box, so it's m times g is the force pulling downward, and the force everywhere in our string, in our cord, is exactly the same. So let's begin with this side. So we have the sum of all the forces acting along the y-axis, so we essentially have the same system here. Tension plus tension, that's the tension in our string, so we have two tensions. So that means tension plus tension. We choose the upward to be positive, downward to be negative. So these two forces are positive, our gravitational force is negative, and we set that equal to zero. So we bring the T's to one side, everything else to the other side, and we find that our tension in our string, in our cord, is 1/2 of M times G. Now let's set up the equation for this pulley. Here we have simply the force due to the pull, our pull or lifting force, equals force of tension. So we have the sum of the forces shown here. So we set the force lift or the force pull is equal to tension. So we saw that from the above step that tension is equal to M times G divided by 2. We plug in M times G, which is 980, divide that by 2, we get 490 newtons. So notice that the force with which we need to pull on our string, on our cord, is half of the force in our part A, as in the example without the pulley. So the pulley has an advantage of 2. In other words, in this system, we need to lift, we need to apply a force that's half of the force